Welcome to my channel Glory with Mathematics. Please subscribe, like and share.
Dear students, let us solve exercise 1.2 of the first chapter number system. The question number 1 is, state whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. The first statement is, every irrational number is a real number. So this is true, because the real number is a set of rational numbers and irrational number. Because real number is the combination of rational number and irrational number. Then second one, every point on the number line is of the form root over m, square root of m, where m is a natural number. So this is a false statement, because no negative number can be expressed as the square root of any natural number. Then question number 3, statement 3, every real number is an irrational number. So this is false, because real number includes both rational number and irrational number. Because real numbers includes both rational number and irrational number. Positive integers irrational? If not, give an example of the square root of a number that is a rational number. So, no, the square roots of all positive integers are not irrational. The answer is no, the square root of all positive integers are not irrational. For example, 4 is a positive integer and square root of 4 is equal to 2. 2 is a rational number. Like another number, that is square root of 9 is equal to 3, square root of 16 is equal to 4, and 3 and 4 are rational numbers. But if we find square root of 2 or square root of 3, so these are irrational numbers. So, the square root of all positive integers are not irrational. Next, question number 3. So, how root 5 can be represented on the number line? You know how to represent root 2 and root 3 on a number line by using Pythagoras theorem. So, let us draw root 5. So, here you have to draw the number line. So, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. Let this is 3. So this distance is 1 unit each. So here you take 2 unit. So let this is A and this is B. So here we have taken AB is equal to 2 unit. So take AB is equal to 2 unit. So at point B, draw a perpendicular line, say BX. So here you have to draw by using your compass or set square. You can draw here a perpendicular line BX. So BX is perpendicular to AB. Then by taking B as center and 1 unit as radius, draw an arc which cuts BX at C. So here you cut 1 unit as BC is equal to 1 unit. So BC is equal to 1 unit. So then join AC. Again we join AC here. So AC will be root 5 unit. So how? Let us prove. In triangle CBA, right triangle, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So this is equal to AB is our 2 unit. So 2 square plus BC is 1 unit. So 1 square. So this is 5. So this implies AC is root 5 unit. So here we got AC is equal to root 5 unit. Again taking A as center and AC as radius, draw an arc that will intersect, so on the number line that point is D. So in the number line AD is equal to root 5 unit. So by taking A as center and AC as radius, draw an arc that intersect the number line at D, so that BD AD is equal to root 5 unit. So this is the procedure how to represent root 5 on a number line. So in this exercise 1.2, question number 4 is to construct a square root spiral. So this is already we have done as an activity. So please follow that video. How to draw a square root spiral.